doesn't need this, okay? She's thrown away two careers, chosen idiot after idiot, and now she's found another one.
You should stop now.
I don't think so.
Well, it's nice to know what you really think of me.
What's going on?
Charlie's having a reaction to the antibiotic.
What?
It's okay. When Charlie comes home, I think we'd really like the place to ourselves again.
Don't do this.
Just go pack your bags, Liv. Be easier if you're not there when I get back.
The article you were going to run was full of lies about Andrew's past, just because he committed the crime of liking me. My life is going to be so much better when I don't have to look at your face.
I think you miss me.
Oh.
We'll get twice the numbers with a male fashion parade, especially when you and the boys get down to Beachwear. Dingo men, I love it.
Zeke has been seen down at the bus shelter near the garage.
What?
Apparently he was asleep on the seat there.
Well, they sure it's Zeke.
I've got to get down.
What, was that the police?
No, it was just some guy. He didn't give me his name, but that's...
How'd he get the number?
Off the poster.
Carl, you have to work with the police!
Carl, I'll give you a lift home.
Oh, no, I'm fine, thanks. Just waiting for someone. Now, I had another response to the posters.
Oh, yeah?
There's a bloke running this morning. He says he's in contact with Zeke. And he's late.
Did he sound genuine?
I know it could be a prank. What if it was genuine and I wasn't here?
Carl, why don't you come home with us?
Oh, no, it's fine. I'll keep waiting. He's probably just delayed.
Are you sure, mate?
Yeah, it's all good. Thank you.
He just looks so sad. I'm going to stop in on Susan later.
Bridget, Declan, just the people I wanted to talk to.
I'll see you guys inside.
Almost didn't recognise you without your nappy on.
Oh, hearty, ha-ha. Listen, instead of photos of me being flashed about the place, how would you like to get in on the act? See, I was thinking about a profile piece for the newspaper. Up-and-coming football stars.
Hmm? Huh. And why would you want to do that?
Because it'd be good for your career and your profile. Just think, sponsors would be falling over each other just to sign you up. Besides, it might help pay for your nappies.
It's nice of you, Paul.
So what's in it for you?
Look, I know things have been difficult between me and your mother. But you'll always be important to me. Have a think about it, all right?
You two talking yet? It's frostier than Narnia in there. Hey, I thought you handled this story about Zeke's bank account really well.
Yeah, it should hook the readers in. Fortunately, it'll just drag out the misery for the Kennedys, though.
It's good news, though, isn't it?
No, not necessarily.
No, Zeke's card could have washed up anywhere. Some lowlife finds it, practices the signature, or gets lucky with a PIN number.
And considering the other evidence, a life jacket, the helmet.
Can I have a look? He's alive.
Sorry?
Zeke. I just had a weird flash.
You psychic or something?
Huh? Oh, yeah, absolutely. Got any spoons you want bent?
How many more suitcases, Lib?
2 or 3.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, it's Steph's house, I guess. She's got every right to kick me out. It's so petty and spiteful. 10 years. We've been best friends for 10 years.
I know. Just give it a day or two, Lib. Okay? She'll back down.
We've had fights before, you know. We've screamed for errands for a bit. I've never seen her like she was today. I need her. You know, with everything that's gone on with Zeke. I need my best friend.
Hey, where are we going?
Here we are, Benny boy. The good old house of Trouser.
This is so much cooler than Steph's house.
It's not forever, Lib.
Okay, stop talking.
Hey, Cal. Lib and Ben are moving in for a while.
Says who?
Says me and hopefully Toad. You know, I thought you could share your room with Ben.
You can hope all you like.
You know, Ben's got some fantastic video games, don't you, Benny boy?
Well, when you put it that way, I've always wanted a butler.
Offer accepted. Thanks, Gal.
Hey, the fridge is in there and I'm feeling a bit thirsty. Coming right up, sir.
Okay, well, they're happy-ish.
Suppose it kind of gives us a chance to live like a family.
Well, I know I'm going to enjoy waking up next to you every morning.
Message. You okay?
Yeah, I'm okay.
Yeah, can I see him?
Yeah, of course. I need to ask you something first.
Mm-hmm.
I want to take action against the doctor who treated him.
But the allergic reaction wasn't the doctor's fault, was it?
She treated him. He was sorry. I want to sue her and the hospital for malpractice.
Steph, on the phone you told me that he was okay.
Yeah, no thanks to that doctor.
Okay, malpractice is very difficult to prove, not to mention messy and expensive.
She put Charlie's life at risk.
His life? Come on.
Well, you think I'm lying?
No, I think you're upset. And this is not the way to deal with it.
Okay, fine. Find someone else.
Okay, all right, I'll do it.
Thanks.
Is there anything else going on here?
No. Just looking after what's mine.
Night, Miranda. Can I still be waiting there? Oh, hang on a sec. Someone at the door. One tick. Oh, hi. Hi, come on in. Yeah, it's Toadie and Kelly. Okay, I will. Thanks, Miranda. Bye.
Hey, saw your light on. Thought we'd pop in.
Yeah, he just wanted to check up on you.
Well, it's Carl I'm worried about. He's gone AWOL again.
Oh, really? Is there anything we can do?
No.
You need to make sure you're getting enough rest.
I'm okay. I'm just sick of feeling so useless.
Oh, where have you been?
Well, I didn't show up, so I went to the soup kitchen and then the salvo shop, but no one's seen him.
God, you have to stop running off like this.
Well, I would have run, but the battery went flat on this damn phone again.
Well, we'll get out of here. Come on, Cal.
Yeah, Carl, is this your backpack?
No, it's Zeke's. Why?
No reason. Night.
Night, guys.
I want you to see Dr. Levi.
What?
Now, you need to talk to someone.
Oh, Susan, we've talked about this. I don't need a shrink. I need your support.
You have my support, but you need professional help, Carl. You need to have some counselling to get through this.
Zeke is alive, okay? I can't tell you how I know that, but I do. I'm not giving up hope.
I thought you might fancy a coffee before work.
Yeah, I'll just grab my stuff.
Okay.
Sam, you ready?
Yeah, I just had Andrew Simpson's lawyer on the phone about that article.
Doesn't anybody have a sense of humour anymore?
See, I told you, you'll have to print a retraction or go in and settle.
Yeah, he's just looking for attention.
So, Kel, you're the psychic. How much do you think we might go settle for?
Mm-hmm.
It's a joke. See you guys later.
Hey, it's okay. She was only joking.
Yeah, I know. Well, it's just not that funny, actually. Sometimes I do get intuitions. You know, it's kind of scary, actually. My mum's the same, and so was my nan. She used to call it her sense.
So you really are psychic?
Not psychic, no. I don't know what you call it.
So this thing with Six?
I mean, I don't know where he is or what's happened, but I don't know. I just have this really strong feeling, this sense that he's alive.
Are you going to tell the Kennedys?
I don't know. I mean, it's a really big thing to get your head around, and in the past it's done more harm than good, so...
Hmm.
No.
What are you doing here?
Dad
is supposed to warn me when you stay over.
Kel, you were supposed to tell him sorry. He was supposed to tell you, Toad.
Sorry, must have forgotten.
You better get used to wearing that. We've moved in.
Here you are, sir. Thank you very much, Alfred.
I won't ask.
No, we'll explain it when you're decent.
Mate, what happened? Was there the meeting about new residents? I missed it.
Sorry, they had nowhere to go and you weren't taking calls.
Nowhere to go?
You haven't heard about Liv and Steph.
What about them?
So part of me actually thinks that Paul's being genuine. The other half is, well, you know, sus.
It seemed really genuine.
Oh, yeah. He always does.
Thanks. So you don't think I should do it?
Well, look, he is right. An article would be really good for your profile.
Yeah, give me some big bucks for Tadpole.
How many times? It's not a Tadpole.
Are you still banging on about Paul Robinson?
He seemed really genuine.
Well, here you go. Check out with Lewis Lane here.
Thanks.
Hey,
hi. Did Paul tell you about his offer?
No, but Rebecca did. What a cheek, huh?
What?
You didn't tell him?
Tell me what?
Your mum broke up with Andrew Simpson because Dad threatened to ruin his reputation.
What?
That was not the only reason.
Oh, yes, it was.
Thanks a lot, Elle.
What? Dick deserves to know what Dad's doing to you.
So that's why you did the flies?
Yeah, that was my idea.
So he's just playing me to get back in your good books.
If he has made you this offer, you should at least think about it.
Yeah, come on, let's go. Thanks for breakfast, Mum.
Bye, Rebecca. Oh, hello.
Hi. Hey.
Goodbye.
Oh, goodbye, sweetheart.
She's lonely.
What?
Well, she's been through a lot lately. She's stuck in that house on her own. I wouldn't like it.
Seems fine to me.
Hi. Sorry I'm late. Two extra people clogging up the bathroom this morning. Libby is not enjoying the house of trousers. She's gagging to get home.
Did your father see?
Yes, I did. Told you it'll get messy. She's already got Tim Collins on the case, and he emailed me this morning. My client is considering whether her duty of care as a doctor requires her to report Miss Stephanie Scully for child neglect.
What?
In that Miss Scully did expose her child to danger whilst engaged in a dalliance with her lover.
That's not true.
Well, it'll read well in the papers.
She wouldn't dare.
Tim will persuade her to reconsider if you drop your case against her.
What, and she gets away with poisoning my son?
That's not what it's about, though, is it?
That doctor hates me, Toad, and I don't blame her.
Then drop the malpractice suit. We won't win. You know, right now, you could do with a friendly shoulder, so why don't you call Libby?
I've got to get to the hospital.
Stay.
Oh, I've got to be with Charlie.
Excusez-moi. Café for my two favourite ladies.
Ah, merci.
Thanks, Lou.
All right, thanks. I'll let him know. Bye.
Hi.
Hey. Hi. Sorry to interrupt. Zeke's bank account has just been accessed again.
What?
I was just speaking to a cop mate of mine about another matter. When a call came in, I said I'd pass it on.
Oh, I knew it.
I'm sorry, Carl, but they caught the guy who's been accessing his account. He found Zeke's wallet on the riverbank the day after the accident.
Ozzy must have climbed ashore there.
They searched the area. There was nothing else.
We'll go back. We'll search it again.
Please. Please.
Maybe you should say something.
I don't know.
Well, if this sense thing really works, then it wouldn't be giving them false hope, would it?
Working today?
Oh, no, I just have to try and get the house and this garden under control. It's just doing my head in.
Well, it's tough all by yourself. You must miss Declan not being under the same roof.
He's not giving you any trouble, is he?
Oh, no. Now, the thing is, I've been thinking about you rattling around in that house on your own. And, well, if you wanted, you could rattle around ours with us. Well, not so much rattle, but cram.
Miranda, what are you trying to say?
I was wondering how you'd feel about moving in with us.
Are you serious?
Of course.
Paul.
I think I'd better go and just...
I'll tell you where you can stick that article.
Come on, Deck.
Oh, come on. Can't tell me that you don't need the money.
No, you can't buy my respect, okay? You can't buy my mum either.
This has got nothing to do with Rebecca.
Just leave her alone.
He's right. We've got to leave the past in the past, okay? I've got a new business to organise. I've got a grandchild on the way. I've got great friends, maybe even a new home. It's my life, Paul. You've got no part in it.
Talk to you?
Okay, sure.
I heard you and Susan and Jared talking at the store.
Yes.
About Zeke.
Yes.
I think you're right. I think he's alive.
What makes you say that?
A feeling. Sometimes I get a really strong sense about things and images in my head, and it's been happening with Zeke. Yesterday I touched his newspaper photo and his bag, and I had these flashes. I saw the water.
How dare you come here with what feelings and flashes? Haven't we been through enough?
They're real, I swear. I mean, that's Zeke's, isn't it? If I just have one more go.
Gee, don't even think about touching this. What is it with you crackpots? Your phone calls and your hoaxes?
Hoaxes? Well, no,
God, you get off on this, do you? Just get off watching people.
I'm sorry. You're right, I shouldn't have come. I'll go. I'm sorry. Sorry.
Thought you'd be here.
Said to return these.
And you're hoping to see her. Come on, come home. Come on.
Ooh, lately we ain't been communicating beyond what needs to be said and done. Short, sharp words like arrows that pierce our skin, let the poison run. You're showing no emotion. I don't think it's noble to be proud. Yes, we take it for granted that we love each other. Can't bring ourselves to say it out loud. I hope we find the connection.
No, Tim, really is my pleasure, mate. Yeah, we should catch up sometime soon. Maybe next available leap year. Bye. Right, well, that's the lawsuit called off. Now maybe Liv and Steph can start sorting themselves out. Yeah, they really need each other right now. Steph's got the Charlie stuff and Libby's got...
Zeke.
Yeah. The two of them falling out. It's really like the apocalypse is coming. You okay? You haven't stolen any of my chips. What?
Do you have any idea what you've done? Carl's been beside himself for weeks. You just had to look at him to see that he was on the edge. And then finally, this morning, he started to listen. Until you barge in with your ridiculous visions.
Susan, I had to see Carl. I don't want him to give up hope.
You stupid, stupid girl. He's right back where he was.
I'm sorry. I know this must be really hard to understand, but I'm only trying to help.
To help?
Yes. Zeke's alive.
Kelly?
No, I know he's alive. Carl was right, and you need to support him.
And you need to stay out of this.
Jack.
How could you do this?
I've got nothing more to say to this husband-stealing piece of...
Neighbours, 6:30 weeknights on 10.
Neighbours, everybody needs good neighbours. With a little understanding, you can find the perfect blend. Neighbours should be there for one another.
Thank you.